Turn to 364. When Jesus comes to reward his servant, whether it be noon or night, faithful to him will he find us watching with our lamps all trimmed and bright. Oh, can we say we are ready?
down and go to sleep and not worry where you're going to be if you wake up dead. That's peace right there.
Amen.
Please stand to your feet, put a smile on your face, get a songbook, turn 52.
As I travel through this pilgrim land, there is a friend who walks with me. Leads me safe through the sinking sand as the cry of cavalry. This would be my prayer, dear Lord, each day that we do the best I can. For I
house this evening. Got a little windy on us, but good and warm in here. Wonder if anybody have a spoken prayer request. Just remember this. There'll be another one.
Remember my family. Remember Tommy. Remember the loss.
Always remember the loss. being of them. Lord knows all about it. Remember this. Being of them.
Hear my dad tonight, said he ain't feeling too well. He's got some doctor's appointments coming up. I'm afraid I will come out good with them. And they were coming to church tonight, and if dad ain't able to come to church, he's feeling pretty rough. So pray for him, Stephen, Sharon, Noah, Megan, Hannah's all on the road. Coming back this evening, remember them, anybody's traveling. Remember Joyce Wilson. Misty and Tammy and Sarah have worked with. Found out today she's got COVID. She's pretty sick. Remember Joyce with the praise. She's got a lot of health problems. Just remember your service tonight. We had a good service today. We thank God for that. We pray for service tonight as well. As any come in, no hope, Lord, we'll be saved. Remember our country, leaders of it. Remember those that's going through valleys. Those that be buried loved ones this week and has buried loved ones, just lift them up to the Lord. All those that's facing surgeries and things, just pray that God will just insert his hand. God's got big hands. He can take care of things.
Sure can.
We just lift them up to the Lord. We desire your prayers. We have all the family we can see saved.
Remember all this. The Lord can intervene in all this.
That's right.
Be another.
My friend Deb is out of the hospital at home, but she still needs prayer. She's still there, but she's got a ways to go. And brother has a surgery tomorrow.
Remember this. Be another. Remember this. Be another.
Also remember.
Remember this.
Also, let's keep lifting up Brad and Brandon and baby to the Lord that God, if that baby were to make insulin and come home. And then let's remember Jess and Nick, Sharon told me this morning they're planning on taking that baby the day before Thanksgiving. She's sort of facing some of the same problems that Brandon was having. So this baby ain't growing. It ain't growing. It's 2 weeks a bit, and they're very concerned. So we need to keep praying that God touch that child and touch her.
Remember all this. Being over. This. Be another. Be another. Be our number one mission.
Right.
To be another. Remember that. To be another. not, how about an unspoken was uplift the team? Who believes the Lord can take care of this by uplifting the hand? Lord can supply all these needs. David Cunningham, would you lead us in prayer?
Someone else.
ever heard this song. Wayne House preached one night and was talking about somebody in his family that sung it. But the message, is what we should be doing. I find myself doing it. Brightly beam, our Father's mercy. Sunday night preached about that in his own way.
Yeah, he did.
Christ is the lighthouse.
That's right.
But we need to be down on the shores reflecting the light from that lighthouse to show them some of the dangers that they don't see. And I think I've told this before, that's how that song was written. As the ship was trying to make it into the harbor, and he seen the lighthouse and he got it to the lighthouse, but unknown to them, there's rocks along the shore, and the ship had crashed into the rocks. And the writer thought in his heart, that's what we need to be. Along the shore, guiding those lost people. His work to do,
right,
for all of us, including me.
Hey,
can't jump real good here at the church. I feel like if I'd offer them $100, they'd probably jumped up and got a hold of the ceiling fans. Might be wrong. Let's stand up and fellowship one another. How about that? You can jump if you want to, if that's your part of fellowship. Don't matter to us. It's good to be in church tonight. My Lord sent Moses down to see King Pharaoh. Amen. Good evening, everybody. Good to be back in church tonight. And good to see everybody that's made it out our way. If you're visiting with us, we're tickled to death to have you. And we want you to feel free to worship the Lord with us. I'm going to be back over in Matthew's Gospel again tonight, chapter 22. Just a few minutes. We'll try not to hold you long. Matthew chapter 22. Verse 34. Let's start reading right there. Y'all stand with us if you want to. But when the Pharisees had heard that he had put the Sadducees to silence, they were gathered together. Then one of them, which was a lawyer, asked him a question, tempting him, and saying, Master, what is the great commandment in the law? Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is likened to it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Father, thank you for your word. Let it lay in our heart and let it blossom into what you'd have it to be. As you said, one sows, one waters, but God, you are the one that gives the increase. Increase it in our lives that we may be fruit-bearing Christians, that we may see souls saved, that we may live in the goodness of your glory. Bless Letterbox Baptist Church, each one that makes up the body. Give us souls for our labor, Father, we pray. Help our sick, heal our land, remove COVID and every distraction out there in the world. Let it be gone in your name, Father. You're the only one can heal it. You're the physician. God, save souls that's nearest hell, wherever they're at right now, before death gets a hold of their body. Save them, Jesus, we pray. We love you. We honor you. We ask you to bless us and help us. In Jesus' name we ask, and all that wanted said amen, amen. And amen. Y'all remember, before I get in the big way of preaching, remember now, Friday night, 6:30, come out and have dinner. Come out. I believe we're having barbecue, I believe is what Stephen told me. So come out. And the younger is going to serve the elder. So I don't, if you're middle-aged, you may just have to get your own plate, because I don't know where you fall in category at, but that'll be all right. No, we won't do you that way. Come out here Friday night if you want a fellowship. Bring who you'd like. We want to have a good time of fellowship. It's getting upon the time of Thanksgiving, and Christians ought to be the most thankful people in the world. Amen. I've got a whole lot to thank God for. How about you? Been good to me. I got a whole lot to thank God for. And I praise him for that. 6:30, Friday night. Come be with us. Before Friday night, the Lord may come. If he's come, I ain't gonna be eating here. Amen. I'll be over there. How about you? So you better be ready in case you ain't here Friday night. And I like this scripture. And I noticed something this evening studying this that I had not never noticed before. But Jesus, when this lawyer came, and a lawyer in the Bible was one that studied the law of God. That's what a lawyer was. They stood in the temple, they taught, they was answer questions and ask questions. They were supposed to know everything about God's Word, the lawyer was. But when they came to him, they came to him tempting him. In other words, they had the wrong purposes in mind. They wanted to publicly make a fool out of Christ and try to prove that he wasn't who he was. But let me tell you something. I believe John was the one that wrote and said, I suppose that the books could not contain the things that he'd done while he was here on this earth. Now, he was manifest in the body for 33 and a third years. And if the books of this world can't hold the things, imagine trying to write them now. Amen? I've got a book. You've got a book. Our life is a book. Amen? And if you included Christ in it, you're going to have some good stories. Some good things to tell, some good testimonies. But notice how they said, you'll love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, all thy soul, and all thy mind. This is the first and the great commandment, and the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Now, if you think about this, look at what is said here. Which is the great commandment in the law? In other words, they just wanted one answer. They didn't want to take the second answer. I want to preach tonight for a few minutes on a thought the Lord gave me on the main thing is still the main thing. How many knows God's Word has not changed? And God has not changed. And the Bible said that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He will not change. Amen. And when He said this is the main thing, then it's still the main thing. Amen. No matter what kind of study that I put out on it, no matter what kind of book that you read about God, no matter what kind of group that you sit in and study about, Jesus answered it this way. You want to know the great commandment? He said, love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind. That leaves nothing out, amen? From the inside out, love God with everything you got. I'd love to see the church love God with everything they got, amen? I'd love to see the church go after the holiness of God, the goodness of God, the blessings of God, the way that people go after the world in the world, amen. Well, you say, why you compare it to that, Preacher Shane? Because it seems like people go out after monetary things of this life with, as old saying is, they go out after it with a passion, amen. My passion as a Christian ought to be to follow God with everything in me. It ought to have so much of the love of God in me that even if I'm having a bad day, they'll say, hey, he's having a bad day, but I know him. He's a child of God. I know her. I've seen her pray. I've saw him sing in church. I've heard her testify. I've saw him put coats on people's backs, put food in people's homes. This is the real deal. This is love. Listen, the love of God goes beyond our six-hour meetings on Sunday. Amen. If we're here at 6 hours, we ain't here 6 hours on Sunday. We're fortunate to be here 6 days, 6 hours a week. If you count Wednesday, amen. But let's just say 6 hours for a good round figure, amen. If we're here in this church actively seeking, praying, and worshiping God, 6 hours don't scratch the surface. And this ain't the only place that we should love God, amen. You should be as passionate out there as you are in here. And God's love should, when it gets inside of you, ought to spill out to people that you're around, amen. I mean, have you ever been around now, a lot of us growed up, how many growed up in church? Ever since you was born, you've been in church somewhere. We've been around it, been with somebody, growed up in church. If you did that, you're fortunate. These young people that stood up here and lined this pulpit this morning, thank God they're growing up in church, amen. Thank God for that, and I pray that they have some experiences in church and hear some singing and get some chill bumps and get to participate in things that says, you know what the preacher was talking about, what my Sunday school teacher was talking about, what the people that sat beside of me was talking about. This stuff is real. We want it to spill over. We want you to just live in the goodness and the peace and the joy of God. And I tell you what, I've been around people before, and I bet you have too as Christians. You've been around people before, but automatically when you start talking to them, you hook up with them in the spirit. And you can sit down right beside each other and get to telling things that God's done. I get to talking about Scripture with one another. I may be praying with one another, or just a good friendly conversation. And buddy, you'll get them feelings right there like you do when you come in here on Sunday morning, and it gets real good, and the Spirit's being poured out. You know why that is? Cause where two or three are gathered in my name, I'll be in the midst. The main thing is still the main thing. Love God with everything in you, amen. You think God didn't love you? Every time you see a cross, that's not just a replica. That's not just a figure. That's not just something that we put out claiming to be Christians. There was a cross that the very Son of God was crucified on. There our sin was conquered. There our debt was paid for. On that cross, all of my shame was nailed to it, and all of yours was nailed to it. All of your failures and your faults was loaded upon the Savior. That, my friend, is love that is beyond our imagination. Love that is beyond words. So I'm telling you tonight, love God with everything in you. Amen. And when you love God with everything in you, it'll make the second one that Jesus included, it'll make it make a lot more sense. And it'll make it a lot easier to do. And what is that? Love thy neighbor as thyself, amen. In other words, care as much about this family as you care much about your family. I'm glad we've never had the problem here at Letterbox with people that'll say or have the attitude of, well, my family's saved, that's all I'm worried about. I'm not worried about this man's family or this lady's family. My family's saved and they're going to heaven, so if they don't make it, I can't help that. No, that ain't our attitude, and I'm glad it ain't. Because we want to see your family saved as much as you want to see my family saved. Everybody here wants to see everybody's family saved. Amen. We won't give up. We'll not quit preaching this book. We'll not quit singing them songs. We won't shut the church doors. We'll not give up. We're going to keep on keeping on, because the main thing is still the main thing, and that is to love the Lord with everything that's in you. Amen. You may have forgotten tonight as a Christian that when Jesus came to this earth and died, he poured every bit of his life out so you could have life. They did not take his life from him. He said, no man can take my life. He freely gave it all over so you could have that more abundant life. Love Him with everything in you, amen. Everything in Him, love Him. And there's something I noticed about the Scripture. As I said when we started, I'd never noticed before. Look at verse 34. When the Pharisees had heard that He put the Sadducees to silence, they were gathered together. They was not going to come around Jesus until the Sadducees was out of the picture. Now the Sadducees came asking Jesus a question because they didn't believe in the resurrection. But the Pharisees and the Sadducees, sometimes they had some discrepancies against each other, and it's almost like the Jews and the Samaritans. And notice how that these Pharisees felt like they was right, and the Sadducees felt like they was right, and they wouldn't come together with Christ while they was all together. They wouldn't go in one place together with Christ. So it said here to one of them, which was a lawyer, he came in and asked him this question. We want to see what he's told these Sadducees. And notice how that second commandment is not what he asked for. He asked for the first one. The first one being love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind. They didn't ask for the second one, but Jesus gave it to them. Because if you're going to do the first one, you can't leave the second one out. Amen to that. If you're going to do commandment number one, it'll make it easier to do commandment number two, number three, number four, all the way down through number 10. But you can't do any of them if you don't have number one right, amen. And here he had number one. He said, love Him with everything in you. And the Bible said, the second is likened to it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. These Sadducees that you wouldn't get together with that don't believe in the resurrection, that I explained to them why there is a resurrection, they got hung up thinking that. A lot of us don't know this tonight, but the Sadducees, most of them only believe the first five books in the Bible, Genesis through Deuteronomy, the books of Moses. And they thought that that was what everything was supposed to hang on. That was just a prelude to what was coming, amen. They didn't realize that. But Jesus pointed out something to them in that Scripture. He said, I am the... They didn't believe in the resurrection, but there's Abraham, a man that was dead before Moses was in the picture, that said, I am the God, not I was the God. He said, I am the God of Abraham, thy father. He is the God of the living, amen. And he explained that to the Sadducees. And when the Pharisees come in the room, they probably felt like I'm more right than anybody else is. Can I explain to you something tonight that we need to keep in check as Christians? Let God be true and every man a liar, amen. He's the one that is always right. We all have different ways of looking at some things in the Scripture, but there's one thing that we've got to agree on. What is that? That's the main thing. If you're going to get to heaven, you better love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. And you better let Him come in, amen. And when He comes in, He'll help you to love your neighbor. How do you know you've passed from death unto life? You got love for the brethren, amen. This is not love that is written down. This is not love that is made up. This is love that is born inside of every person that becomes a child of God. You'll never get it until Jesus comes in your life. Amen. So, when the Pharisees got there, this wasn't what they was wanting. You know why? Because Jesus said, even though they're wrong about the resurrection, love them as you love yourself. Now, this is hard to do. Even though there's people out there that have fell by the wayside, even though there's people out there that'll hate you because you're Christians, love them like Jesus would. Show them the gospel. And let me tell you this. If they don't accept it, then Jesus said, shake the dust off your feet. Amen? We have an obligation as Christians to preach this gospel to every nation, to every kindred, and to every tongue. Amen? And it's going out in places right now it's never been out in. And you and I are getting to witness that and experience that. And when the last message is preached on this earth, the Lord's coming. Amen. Now, when's the last message? We don't know. That's up to God when He sends it. But one day it will be preached, and then the Lord will come. because that gospel will then be fulfilled that every tongue has heard, every ear has heard the gospel preached, and they've understood that Jesus is the Christ, that He's the Savior of all mankind, amen. But church, until that time comes, let me remind you something. The main thing is still the main thing. Maybe you're trying to do something in a ministry. Maybe God has laid something on your heart to do and you're struggling with it. You're trying to perfect it. You're trying to figure out exactly how I should do these things. I want to be pleasing unto God. I want my ministry to flourish. I want to see souls saved. I want to see the hungry fed. I want to see people come back to the house of God that's been gone for so many years. Can I tell you how to do that? You've got to go back to the main thing, amen. Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy strength, and love your neighbor as yourself, amen. Because I'm telling you, if we get away from this, then we're getting away from the purpose of who we are as children of God. You can't love God until you know God, amen. These people out there can sing about God. They can write movies about God. They can play in plays about God, but you'll never love God until you know God, amen, and are known of God. And when you're known of God, that means God has came in and He's an active part of your life. I'm glad Jesus is an active part of my life, amen. I'd hate to try to stumble out that door without Christ in my soul. I'd mess up. I'd fall down face first before I ever got off the steps without Jesus, amen. The main thing is still the main thing. What's the main thing, preacher? Well, Jesus said it. So if you know that you're lost, the main thing is to get saved. And then you'll figure out what love is all about. And these people, I meet them all the time. Preacher, I come to church, I ain't got a dress to wear. Well, I don't either, but I go to church every Sunday. You all die if I walked in here with a dress on. And I'd hope somebody would tell me to take it off. But now, I said that as being funny, but listen. As long as you got clothes on your back, come in the church. Amen. Come in the church. All's welcome in the house of God. They can't hear it. Amen. They can't hear it if we ain't preaching it to them. And can I tell you this tonight? Oh my goodness. It's real easy. If I'm sitting at home and I'm watching the TV and the preacher says something that don't lay just right with me, I can change the channel. It's hard to change the channel in here. Amen. When you get in the house of God, it's a special place. You can't hardly change the channel. You might drop your head and try to get your head on something else, but let me tell you something. Holy Ghost conviction is a stout thing. And when it get a hold of you, it get a hold of you, amen? And I'm glad God got a hold of me one day, and I'm glad He didn't turn loose. But I'm glad I turned loose. And when I turned loose, I came to Him. And when I came to Him, He turned all heaven loose. And by the glory of God came right down and filled my soul. Anybody else had that experience? I'm telling you, it's a wonderful thing, amen. When you get saved by the grace of God, then you realize what the main thing is. The world has got away from the main thing, amen. That's the reason that it's in the shape that it's in. That's the reason crime rates are through the roof. That's the reason people are laying on the street corners starving. That's the reason that places are shut down. That's the reason that we have the corruption that we've got in this land. That's the reason, my friend, that you have to be careful when you get in your car, when you're walking out of Walmart in the middle of the night from getting your groceries. That's the reason that you just can't pick anybody up walking down the road anymore. Times has changed, but God has not. The reason it's changed is the world has got away from the main thing. This country used to be in love with Jesus, and until it gets back in love with Him, it's not going to get better, amen. There's not a politician can fix it. Say amen right there. We need godly men and women in every office, from the White House to the courthouse, amen. They need to be everywhere saying, let God fix this. But until that happens, man cannot fix what man messed up. The Bible proves us that. They went, and you want me to tell you how it proves that? We're going to give an invitation song. When Adam sinned in the garden, what's the first thing they done? They sewed fig leaves together. They tried to take fig leaves, and they tried to make clothes out of them. But it did not cover what needed to be covered. So what did God do? God took animals and slayed them and took their skins, Brother Ronnie, and made coats, put it on Adam and Eve. Have mercy. Man couldn't fix it. 2003, I don't know how many thousand years later we are. I'm not good with timelines. I know we're 2,000 years past Christ, but however long before Christ that was, till now, we still ain't fixing things. Say amen right there. And we never will fix things. The only way you'll have peace in your life is to go back to the main thing. You know what's wrong with churches today? Uh-oh, here comes preachers preaching on other churches. No, church as a whole, the body of Christ. You want to know what's wrong with church as a whole today? They've got away from the main thing. They have. They don't love God with all their heart, with all their soul, and with all their mind. If they did, they'd be more active for God. Amen right there. We'd be beating the bushes more than we are. Amen right there. We'd be out, and it wouldn't just be a Sunday thing. It'd be an everyday thing that we'd be about the Father's business. Jesus knew he had just a few years when he walked into Jerusalem. And he said, I must be about my Father's business. We may just have a few minutes. We have no idea. To a few hours, to a few years, we don't know. But God could come at any time. And I'm glad when God comes, I still know what the main thing is. Amen. Do you know what the main thing is? I hope you know that the main thing is still the main thing. And that you need to exercise the love that God has placed in your life. If the church don't exercise the love that God has placed in our life, how can we expect the lost to come in the house of God? How can we expect people to be saved? How can we? I tell you something, church. I love y'all with everything in me, but I can't save a soul. You all know that. I can stand here and preach till I'm blue in the face. I can't make them walk that aisle. I can't make them get down there and pray. But when we, the body, get in one mind and one accord and come into this house and say we're here for the main reason, and that is to do the main thing, then, buddy, it's going to be awful hard for them to resist the conviction of the Holy Spirit. Amen. They're going to be sitting there, and I've had that white knuckle syndrome where I've gripped that seat. When we're all standing there in invitation and our mind is on somebody getting saved, I'm telling you, it's hard for them to not acknowledge that God is dealing with their heart. Let's get in the focus of the main thing, amen, and see what happens as a church of God. Stand your feet with us tonight. The main thing, still the main thing right now. Get everything off your mind. Get everything off your mind. Somebody, somewhere, maybe in this church, is this close to coming to God. You know, in the morning I say, Keith, I sit somewhere right in that area. The only thing I remember is taking that first step. Buddy, the rest of them wasn't nothing. Amen? Fell right in his arms, Brother Earl. Felt so good. Felt so good. And I believe the moment that I stepped out, I stepped into the arms of Jesus. And I believe just like we had all these kids up here this morning and all of you standing back there rejoicing, I believe in heaven they was not rejoicing, saying, Shane. They wasn't rejoicing, saying, Letterbox. They saying, glory to the Lamb of God. Amen. He saved another. His work is not in vain. Now they'll do that same thing tonight. Heaven's open 24/7. God's throne's never shut down. So if you've got a need tonight, get your mind on God. It's not about opinions, ideas, or reflections. This is real life. As I said a few Sundays ago, this ain't no fairy tale. This ain't three little pigs and a big bad wolf. We've got Satan out there that's trying to destroy this world as we speak. But we've got God on the throne that the Bible says greater is he that's in us than he that's in this world. So get your mind on Christ right now and listen to him as he speaks as we sing his song.
Number 81.
Main thing is still the main thing. main thing. Still the main thing. Was shed for me. The main thing. God speaking to hearts. Me come, O Lord, to thee, O Lamb of God. Lamb of God. I come to you, Lord, realizing I need to be doing the main thing. Who rid my soul? One dark spot. So how about it tonight? There's time to pray. Come, let us reason together. Come now, the Bible says, let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Though they be crimson, they shall be as wool. So, God can clean you up from the inside out. God can save and seal and sanctify you. Make you a new creature, brand new creature in Christ. How about it? How about it? I believe, Lord. So you've got time to pray. There's still people praying. They may be praying for you. They could be praying for you right now in this place. If you're here and you don't know God, you need to come running down this aisle and realize that time is almost over. Day's about done. That thy blood shed for me. For me. Gave his life for me. For me. I'm not worthy.